process of changing a stator. This unit is FloQuip EM30. We're going to start out by taking off this curved line right here. I'm just going to use an adjustable wrench. Loosen this up. This other one up over here as well. Just as a reminder, anything past this, what we call the poppet valve, anything on this side of it going through here, going through the stator and the rotor going through there, this housing coming up through here to the drawdown tube, you don't want to clean any of that with water. Only should be a neat polymer in that line. And the water is going to come through this line. And that's where it mixes and creates a solution. And actually, right here in this bar is a static mixer. You can see the welds right here. Loosen this, holding on this stator, and there should be a 3/8. Let's see, where's the 3/8? There it is. Be a 3/8 nut behind there. Just use a flathead on the front side. This is bracket. Alright. And we should be good there. Alright. I'm just going to go ahead and take my pipe wrench here. So then the threads are broke loose. what we're going to want to do is, let me get a pen. What we want to do is, because this, the way this rotor is turned in there, typically you would think to take it counterclockwise off of this and turn it left, but instead, what we also want to do is we want to lock in this, we want to try to lock in this rotor. I'm just going to put a screwdriver there and hold it a little bit. So instead of turning left here, what we want to do is we want to turn right. And this stator should turn right off of the rotor when we turn this to the right. And as you can see, it's just coming right off. And there it is. So there is your stator, and right there. And if you was going to replace this stator, you would want to pull this piece for the bracket. You would just want to slide that right off of there, and then you would want to put that probably in a vise, take this portion off from here up, put that on the new stator, and you want to do the reverse of what we just did. If you see in there, there's some gel, as you can see in there. Probably be good to take this whole thing apart and get all that gel out of there. Take this housing off. But right now, what we're going to do, we'll just leave this off of there. And then we'll look at how we take out the packing. Taking the this piece off the where the packing goes in, and this piece right here, as you can see, it goes here. You put this side on one screw, you put that side on the other screw, and these two are going to come together as so, and then this is tightened down. And here's the packing is right here. This should be 1/4 inch graphite packing. And as you tighten down, this should push that packing and tighten it down on the rotor. So we're gonna bring the camera over. Packing fits in. Now we can take, I have a tool from Granger, it's right here, it's to pull the packing out. You can take this tool in there and you can maneuver it to get that packing out, or something I've used is just from the automotive parts store, just a pick set right here. Take that pick right there and pull that packing out that way. And as you can see, I'm getting that packing piece out.